Hello y'all, this is Red Flood, a mod for Hearts of Iron 4, set in a world where no one was able to win World War I. We're going to play as the German Socialist Republic, a nation created by revolution and civil war. In the years leading up to 1936, it has progressed well, and when the economic depression hit while its rivals suffered, it was relatively unaffected. With a loyal army and support from the people, Germany stands as a force to be reckoned with. Starting the mob, we got some background information. There is other stuff here, but I'll just go over the events centered around the Great War. As World War I fizzled out, the French army collapsed. Russia fell into chaos after the death of Tsar Alexei. Germany had the Spartacist uprisings. Britain survived. Japan got a colonial empire. And the USA doubled down on isolationism. The German Socialist Republic, or the GSR, does have its own faction, and it is named the Third International. The other members are Hungary, Luxembourg, Brazil, and Cuba. As far as focuses go, the first thing we need to do is have the 1936 Reich Träte Congress, because that will open up the different political paths Germany has. The chairman of the Council of People's Commissars announces he will not run for re-election. This means the country leader we began with will be leaving us soon. All of the German army has been moved to the Swiss border to watch out for any possible threat of invasion that totally exists. Let's take our two fleets, the Ostseeflotte and the Volksmarine, and combine them together to make one big def stack blob. The Politburo must choose a new candidate for the position of chairman. It doesn't really matter who is picked here, so let's go with the guy they already had in mind. The Congress has occurred. We have four options to pick from for who can lead the GSR. Let's go with the first one on the top left, the NMAPD. With the decision made, we have unlocked the NMAPD victory focus. After that, the path will split, so evidently, we got another choice to make. A rift in the party has appeared. It's breaking apart, so we must go with one of two factions. The two sides are the Pagan Socialist and the National Communist, led by Joseph Goebbels. Let's pick the option on the right that says Comrade Goebbels has betrayed the vanguard. With that done, the flag has changed. The ruling party ideology has become Vanguard Socialist, and the new country leader is Ernst Graf zu Reventlow. Ernst Graf zu Reventlow historically was a journalist and a Nazi politician known for his affiliation with the German faith movement, which wanted to move Germany away from Christianity to a religion based on Germanic paganism mixed with Nazi ideas. In the focus tree, we'll do Heidnischer Sozialismus, which translates to pagan socialism in English, then go down in complete conversion of a nation, put Jesus and Jehovah into the pantheon, and Kirchen and Blueshauser. A whole part of the focus tree is dedicated to foreign policy, but first we need more than 45 divisions and at least 400,000 manpower worth of divisions in the field to unlock it. We start off with 208,000 or 208,000, so we need to almost double the size of the army. Our plan for that is to just spam troops and deploy them as soon as possible. On the other side of the world, the Japanese Civil War has started. The combatants are Revolutionary Japan and Imperial Japan. The ideology of Imperial Japan is despotic, while their opposite, Revolutionary Japan, is Vanguard Socialist, the same ideology as the German Socialist Republic. A civil conflict nearby Germany has taken place. This one consists of the Austrian Reich versus the Austrian Commune. The Austrian Commune didn't do well at all and lasted less than a month. More strife in Asia, this time in Korea, who has their own civil war. It has led to the emergence of another vanguard socialist state, though. We must use a military doctrine. Let's go with what Germany usually does in Hoi 4, that being mobile warfare. After we get through the early part, we'll go down the Blitzkrieg branch, unsurprisingly. The Japanese Civil War comes to a close. Revolutionary Japan has come out on top. We have acquired a national spirit called Wotan and Jesus. The description tells us that Wotan or Odin and Jesus are both in the same pantheon. Jesus is to act as the god of mercy to the pagan socialist. More focuses, we will do Volksding and Reichsräte Congress and reconstruct the Erdmännsäule. For context, the Erdmännsäule was a pillar kind of object that is said to have had an important role in Germanic paganism centuries ago. It was apparently destroyed by Charlemagne. War has begun in Russia. It is being fought by the Novorossian General Government and the Russian Empire. In Africa, the Ugandan Commune appears and breaks away from the UK and it will most likely get dogpiled by the British and their faction. The Volksting, a council of great chiefs of the Germanic faith, has been established. It is to act as a counterweight to the very powerful Reichsräte Congress, who played a big role in choosing the German leadership earlier. Our army has grown a lot. That means we can do the focus, spread the revolution. After that, we'll do Pan Germanismus and march into the Alps. The last one I said will give us a war goal on Switzerland and Austria upon completion. For our air doctrine, let's go with battlefield support, because usually close air support aircraft are very, very effective. The Orenburg sovereign state to the east finds itself expanding into the former Southeastern Union, who had a case of country go explode, and now there are like 9 different countries in its old land. Continuing the foreign policy part of the focus tree and starting a special pagan branch, we'll do support local belief systems, revenge for 772, and another Teutoburg. Erich Manstein is going to lead an army of red German soldiers to invade the Swiss in what is totally a preemptive strike and not at all a planned assault. The Austrian Reich is making a move themselves. They have gone to war with the Czechoslovak Kingdom. This could be a good opportunity for us to attack in combination with the Hungarians. A few of the GSR commanders have a trait named Former Imperial that gives them a planning speed buff. I guess it also shows they've been around for a while. There has been a slight change in focus order. Instead of revenge for 7072, we will go with a focus below Reconstruct the Ermine Soul called Soldiers Worship Tur. Tur being an old Germanic pagan deity. Here he is to act as what I assume to be the god of war. Austria is being guaranteed by Italy, and if their focus is anything to go by, they may soon be guaranteed by the UK. We will attack as soon as possible because of this, even if it will involve taking out the Italians. With our attack starting, we called in Hungary, including the Czechoslovak Kingdom. This forces the Austrian Reich to battle on 3 fronts. Italy, who was drawn into the conflict because of reasons stated earlier, is throwing a good amount of divisions at our forces in the Alps. The Hungarians seize Vienna, the new Austrian capital for a time being, will be in Laibach in Slovenia. Some more focuses for this bunch. I will try to explain some of the names, beginning with Lovers Worship Freya, a goddess of love, then Workers Worship Wieland, a master blacksmith, Farmers Worship Osteria, I think this may mean Ostera, a spring goddess, and Sailors Worship Rhenus, a river god of the Rhine. Austria fell, that just leaves Italy. What we're going to do is use a portion of the army to keep the Italians busy while the rest of the divisions move into position. With no one really there to guard the northeastern part of the country, we're just going to sweep down and launch an offensive. We're going to make a defensive line stretching from La Spezia to Bologna and use a armored division to rush Rome. The Kingdom of Italy at best has 46 divisions. They're going to lose a lot of them around Lombardy because they are getting encircled. With that going on, we're still going to advance into the southern part of the peninsula. Once these isolated enemy units are gone, that will free up a lot of our troops so they can be used elsewhere. Because this war will be over soon, let's do another foreign policy focus earlier than I expected. This one is Frisian und Niederlande. It will give us a war goal on the Netherlands. The conflict in Italy is over. We puppeted them and Montenegro, their new names are the Italian Popular State and Vanguardist Montenegro, respectively. The Dutch are next. There isn't really a strategy here, it's just throw everything we have at them until we win. Our standard infantry template for the rest of the game will be a classic 20 width. It should have the firepower we need to face any obstacles we come across. The next big focus we're doing is reclaim the Anglo-Saxon. This one is centered around invading the United Kingdom. While the fight with the Netherlands is wrapping up, we'll go ahead and start the next one with the UK. We got naval invasions planned and everything already. Doing more of the political path, let's complete We All Worship Donar. Donar being another name for Thor, Wotan Cult, and Fordan Alfata. A few German divisions successfully landed. We'll rapidly reinforce them where we can so we don't lose this opportunity. Update on the Dutch situation. We annexed the Netherlands proper, but made the Dutch East Indies into a puppet. I hope we don't get kicked off of Britain because the German Navy has been wiped off the map and so has any chance of naval superiority. There is a dock strike in the city of Hamburg. Can you guys do this when we're not in a war? The division we had in Hull was defeated, so that means the German army will flood into Scotland. As more soldiers arrive, we'll start using them to fan out and take the British countryside. The issue of sexuality, let's go with the choice that boosts the popularity of vanguard socialism and also gives us base stability at the cost of political power. The British have done a naval invasion on what was the Netherlands. Sadly, we didn't leave any troops there, but the Cubans are present and they will have to stop the British. Enemy resistance in England seems very light. With that said, we're going to take their capital of London. That's over. As a result, we have even more puppets. Of note is the Socialist Republic of Great Britain and South Africa, who each has their own unique flags and unique leaders. These two countries will be of good use to the Third International faction. Let's complete revenge for 772 finally. This will give us a war goal on accelerationist, avant-garde France. France will be attacked from as many directions as possible, be it from Italy or Germany itself. We also got troops ready to deal with Fiume, a French ally. We're also going to make sure to call in Brazil so they can give us aid where we need it. You can see here by looking at the numbers, the Third International has doubled the amount of divisions the French League Solar faction has in the field. One thing that has been ignored for a long time is the Bavarian question in Germany. We might as well get it out of the way. Look at the British go. They're doing a D-Day all by themselves, and it's working. What to do with Bavaria? Let's go with the non-violent choice. That will settle the issue once and for all. The French capital was captured, so it was moved to Bordeaux. In response, we are doing a naval invasion to take that. The League Solar was crushed, France is made into the French People's Republic, and Fiume is now the Socialist Republic of Fiume. Carrying on with more war-related focuses, let's do reclaim West Prussia, take Prussia, liberate the Sudeten, and free the Slavs. So that's going to give us a whole lot more war goals once all of these focuses are done. We got to battle Poland for West Prussia. They have their own faction called the Intermarium, but at this point we have almost 120 divisions, so let's take them on. We're marching into Poland. The results so far have been mixed. We can take on their country and all their allies alone, but it will cost us a bit of manpower. Yugoslavia demands Slovenia, even if it will start a war. No, just no. Combat ends in Eastern Europe for now. Poland has become a puppet and so has Lithuania and Ukraine. We didn't take any of Belarus's land, so they managed to survive. We're going to strike at Prussia and Czechoslovakia at the same time, because why not? Once Free to Slavs is done, we'll complete Vereinte Deutsche, and that will be the end of our foreign policy adventures. The Russian Empire is going to be one of our last opponents. They have just been chilling since that civil war earlier, so they have had time to build up a large military. Belarus is going to be invaded just so we can have a wider front with Russia, and thus more room to operate. Yugoslavia is having issues with our puppet Montenegro, I think, so we're at war with them too. We have no one there, so let's hope our allies can hold them off. Belarus capitulated. That means we should be able to hit the Russian Empire with a surprise attack from Belarusian territory. Yugoslavia was handled, but in other news, our good friend Brazil has gotten into a war with all their neighbors and the USA in their quest to dominate South America. Soviet Russia has been made a thing, and with that, it is clear that the Third International is the undisputed master of Europe. We're going to help the Brazilians in some of their wars. Ignore the Americans, they just sort of roam wherever they want. Argentina was made into a German puppet. The next thing we're going to do is make the same thing happen to Chile and Ecuador. That's it. This means the Third International is huge. But the real, I guess you could say, crazy thing is that Germanic paganism has made a grand return to the world on a national scale. The video is going to stop here. If you enjoyed the mod, make sure to check it out in the description below. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to like and subscribe. Leave a comment. Have an awesome day. I'll see y'all later. Bye.